Good morning, grade 5 students. It's Ms. Badr speaking. I hope you're okay, guys. In this video, we are going to learn the addition and subtraction of fractions where the parentheses are included. So what do you think I start with to reach the correct answer? I start first with the fraction inside the parentheses. As you see, inside the parentheses, I have a 3 over 8 plus 1 over 4. And then I deal with the third fraction. Let's consider this example. Inside the parentheses, I have 3 over 8 plus 1 over 4. I have to add them. But make sure you have the common denominator. The common denominator of 8 and 4, to find it, we list the multiples of 8, which are 8 and 16 and so on, and the multiples of 4, which are 4, 8, and so on. The common multiple is 8, so the common denominator will be 8. As you see here, in the 3 over 8, I already have the denominator 8, so I keep it as it is. Plus, to get denominator 8, I multiply the 4 by 2, so I multiply the numerator by 2. And I get 2 over 8. I bring down the minus sign, and I bring down the fraction. Now I can add the two fractions since I have the same denominator. So 3 plus 2 is equal to 5 over 8. I bring down the minus sign and the fraction. Now I want to subtract these two fractions, but I don't have the same denominator. So again, I find the common denominator. 8 is a multiple of 2, so the common denominator is 8. Now I keep the 5 over 8 as it is. I subtract the half. But I have to find the denominator 8. So I multiply the 2 by 4 and I multiply the numerator by 4. I get 4 over 8. I have now the same denominator. So I subtract 5 minus 4 is equal to 1 over 8. Remember, your final answer always should be in simplest form. And here my answer is in simplest form. Now let's consider this example. I have here 4 over 5 minus 1 over 2 minus 2 over 10, which are inside the parentheses. So, as I said, we start with the parentheses. Now, I bring down the 4 over 5 down. I bring the minus sign and I find the common denominator of 10 and 5. Since 10 is multiple of 2, so the denominator will be 10. Now to get denominator 10, I multiply the 2 by 5. So I multiply the numerator by 5 and I get 5 over 10 minus 2 over 10. Now I can subtract 5 minus 2. But first I bring down the 4 over 5 and the minus sign. 5 minus 2 is equal to 3 over 10. Now I can remove the parentheses since I get only one fraction. Again, I don't have the common denominator. So, I have to find the common denominator. 10 is a multiple of 5, so my common denominator is 10. To get denominator 10, I multiply the 5 by 2, so I multiply the 4 by 2, and then I get 8 over 10 minus 3 over 10, which is equal to 5 over 10. As I said, I have to write my answer in simplest form. So here my fraction is not in simplest form. As I know that 5 and 10 have a common factor, which is 5. So I can divide by 5, which is equal to 1 over 2. So now my answer is in simplest form. Thanks for watching.